Good morning.
Thank you, Lord, for just allowing us to be in His presence this morning. We praise God. This is the second Sunday in March, so we just want to thank God because this is Resurrection Month. This is Resurrection Month that we celebrate. And at the end of the month, we'll be celebrating the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So as we stand all over.
Marilyn, you can read the daily greeting. Yeah.
Good morning. I have no problem. We call back the Lord just to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to see another day.
Yes.
We thank you, Lord, for waking us, continue to bless us, protect us as we go through our days.
Thank
Lord,
you.
Lord, we just thank you for all you've done, everything you're going to continue to do.
Thank you.
Lord, we ask you to continue to bless our country, bless all of our leaders, bless our church,
yes.
Bless our pastor, bless our community, and bless all of the other churches that are striving to do your will, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
continue to bless us and protect us. Things seem like they're getting worse, but we just ask you, Lord, to continue to take care of us.
Please,
we ask you, Lord, continue to watch out for our children, wherever they go. Just look out for them, Lord. And then we ask you, too, Lord, too, we thank you that you will be taking care of all those who are sick and shut-in.
Yes.
Bless all of them. We ask you, Lord, to give a special blessing on Gary and Marcella as he continues to improve.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
we ask you, Lord, to continue to look out for Judy and her husband as she continues to help him improve also.
Yes.
Lord, we just thank you. And then we ask you, Lord, to continue to look out for all of those that are in prison.
Bless you.
Sick and shut-in, homeless.
Yes.
Wherever they may be. This is my prayer this morning in Jesus' name.
In your name, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Scripture this morning is Psalm 91, verses 9 through 13. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against the stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shall not trample under feet.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
And thank you, Phoebe, because I forgot to do my daily prayer this morning. Psalms 104, 24 through 35. How many times are your works, Lord, in wisdom you've made them all? God made them all. My three-year-old son, Xavier, squeezed my hand as we entered the Monterey Bay Aquarium in California. Pointing to a life-size sculpture of humpback whale suspended from the ceiling, he said, "Enormous!" His wide eyes joy continued as we explored each exhibit. We laughed at the artist's splish splash during feeding time. We stood in silence in front of a large glass aquarium window, mesmerized by the golden brown jellyfish dancing in the electric blue water. God made every creature in the ocean, I said, just like he made you and me, Xavier whispered. Wow. In Psalms 104, the psalmist acknowledges God's abounding creation and sang, in wisdom you made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. He declared, there is the sea, vast and spacious, teeming with creatures beyond number, living things, both large and small. He proclaimed God's generous and satisfying provision for all he created. He also affirmed that God had determined the day of each one's existence. We can join the psalmist in singing this declaration of devotion. I will sing to the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. Every creature that exists, from the big to the small, can lead us to praise because God made them all. When has exploring the wonderful world God made led you to praise him? How has God used his creation to deepen your faith in his power and provision? All-powerful creator and sustainer of all, you are so worthy of my praise. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
That is our follows. Morning worship services each first, second, third, and fifth Sundays at 9 a.m. Resurrection Sunday is March 31st, the fifth Sunday. Bible says each Tuesday night at the Pastor Home address, and you can join us via Facebook and on the conference line. Neighbors Blessed Neighbors will be Saturday, March 23rd at noon here at Community Center. Good Friday and Communion service will be at Shiloh Missionary Baptist Church, March 29th at 7 p.m. on Walnut Street in Wilmington. Our sick and shut-in list is Willie Garrett, Nora Crawford, Cynthia Hennett, And our prison ministry director is right around the time coming.
Amen. 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 To God be the glory. To God be glory. Thank God for all that has been done and said on this morning. And we'd like to thank those who have blessed us this month. Amen. This week. Amen. We thank God for Sister Constance and Ira Brady, better known as Peggy and Leon. Amen. Who is celebrating on yesterday their, I don't know how many wedding anniversaries. And I forgot to ask you when I talked to her and was congratulating her, but they're celebrating their wedding anniversary and his birthday.
Oh, wow.
On March 9th. Amen.
Amen.
To God be the glory. To God be the glory. So that young couple has has gone to Myrtle Beach for several days.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Still doing what God has put them there to do. Lord, try to multiply the plants to earth. Lord, to God be the glory. We thank God for Michelle Randall. Amen. For her giving out of Annapolis, Maryland. Amen. And one of our board members. We thank God for Sister Beverly Terrain. Amen. Who sow a seed in us every month. We thank God for her. Nicole Ellaby, who sows a seed every month. Amen.
Amen.
Oliver Ellaby, who sows the seed every month.
Amen.
Amen. To God be the glory. So we thank God for them. We thank God for them. And we just thank Sister Alma Richburg. Amen.
Amen.
Who not only sows the seed with us monetarily, but is here on the fourth Saturday. Amen.
Helping
us as we do neighbors to neighbors. To God be the glory. We thank God. We thank God for that that we're able to do. We thank God for that we're going to do, because he's been dealing with me about some things that we need to be doing. I don't want to be idle when it comes to doing what he asked me to do.
Amen.
And he's told me I've been idle for a few years now, so I need to get busy in him. And I see a change in my life because I said, Lord, forgive me. But not do what I should have been doing.
That's right.
I see a change just by acknowledging it with him.
Yeah.
So I thank God for that. I thank God for that. He's going to bless us. Sister Marilyn and I go to a women's retreat on Wednesday.
Wednesday.
Amen. We'll be going to a women's retreat. And I'm asking God also to bless the Living Bread to do a women's retreat on next year. Amen.
Amen.
We'll do a women's retreat on next year. I'm also asking him to bless us because Pastor Pierce, Gary Pierce, amen. He blesses me every morning with an encouraging word.
Amen.
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 He blesses me every morning. And he will be finishing the extension that he's doing on his church sometime this year. So I'm asking God to allow us to be able to take a van. If any more want to go, take a bus. And we go down and bless him.
Amen.
Amen. I'm asking God for that. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. He is a homeboy.
Yes, he
Amen.
Is.
Amen.
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 And he's excited in the Lord with all that he does. And I thank the Lord for him. But every morning he blesses me with an encouraging word from the Lord. And I thank the Lord for that. As we look to the Lord in prayer.
Reverend Jordan, you forgot an anniversary in March.
Baby, Rihanna is 56 years.
56 years? Oh my God. That's a long time.
It is.
I'm good. Yeah.
That's a long time. Amen. To God be the glory. And this month, Brother Jackson Jordan and I will be celebrating 36 years.
Amen.
Amen. That's
when
all
this
right.
month?
March 18th.
Just be here back.
We will.
Yes.
We will. Oh, and then there is Women's Day at
James.
Yes.
On March 17th, yes. Third Sunday in March, Women's Day. Sister Marilyn is the one of the co-chairs for that. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. To God be the glory. 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 Let us look to the Lord. Let us look to the Lord for all that He has done. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. We praise your name, God. We bless your name, Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy. And while we're coming to the altar, this is our altar call. This is when you pray. You pray. Because you know what God has done for you.
Yes.
You know what you want God to do for you. Mm-hmm. And you continue to ask God to do things for you.
Yes.
We're blessed that Sister Christina, amen, she's been awarded the store in Wyville. That's a little far for us to travel to shop. But amen.
Amen.
You're going to ask God that He bless her going out and her coming in every day in her stack.
Yes,
amen.
Yes,
amen. And work with her in letting it be the best store on the Eastern Shore of North Carolina.
All right.
We thank God for that.
Yes.
We thank God. We thank God. We thank God.
Yes.
For God is awesome. We thank God for Brother Lee, who every Sunday
yes.
finds his way to come.
Yes.
And worship with us. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. We thank God. We thank God.
Yes.
We thank God.
Mm.
We thank God.
Yes.
We thank God for Brother Gary. We thank God
yes.
for him.
Yes.
He's moving about. My all Lord. Down to the mailbox, spinning. Getting stuck. Because he wanted to do it on his own.
All right. Love.
And we thank God.
Yes,
and he's given him the strength and the ability to continue to move and have his being in him and know what he needs to do.
Yes,
we thank
yes,
God.
Thank you, God.
We thank God for yes. Sister Marcella as she worked with him every day.
Yes, Lord.
Bring her a 3-day job so she can be home.
My Lord.
She finally retired for real.
Amen.
So God, we thank you.
Thank you, God.
We thank you.
Yes, yes.
We thank you. Heavenly Father, you're awesome.
Yes, you are.
You're awesome in all that you do. And God, we thank you from the bottom of our hearts
yes,
for
Lord.
Everything that you do.
My Lord.
You say in all things and give you thanks. So God, we thank you.
Yes,
Lord. Lord, I thank you for my husband as he come out and make sure that everything is well when we come into this building.
Yes, God.
God, we thank you.
Thank
I thank you,
you
for how he takes care of our home. And I thank you, God, that he is the head.
Yes.
Of our household. So God, I thank you.
Thank you, God.
I thank you and I praise you. I give you glory. Thank you, God.
Yes.
Lord, just continue to bless. Continue
Jesus.
To bless.
Yes.
Continue to bless, Lord. Mm. Continue to bless all our children. Lord, we lift up to you, Tony Elvin. We
yes,
lift
Lord,
Carlos
Jesus.
Elvin.
Yes, God.
God, you know them. You wonderfully made them. Brother Algernon Mack, you made them, God.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
You know them from the top of their heads to the bottom of their ears. You know who they are.
Bless Lord Jesus.
And you know their purpose.
Yes, God.
God, we thank you.
Thank you, God.
We thank you.
Bless you.
We praise your holy name.
Yes.
We praise God and thank God for our little worshiper.
Yes.
Thank
yes,
you,
Lord
God.
Jesus. Yes, yes.
Thank you, God. Lord, we thank you for everything. We thank
yes.
you for everyone who's watching today, for our Facebook family.
Yes.
Heavenly Father,
thank
we
you, Lord.
Thank you for them.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. Allow us to continue to give you the glory, give you the praise in all that we say and do. Everything that have breath. Let it praise the Lord.
Yes.
Let it praise you today, God.
Yes.
Not just
yes.
today, but every day.
My Lord.
God, we thank you.
Thank you, God.
We thank you.
Yes.
This is our prayer in Jesus' name. We pray and everybody say,
amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. The question was asked, do you praise the Lord? That's what that question was
yes.
in the Daily Bread this morning. Do you pray the Lord? Praise the Lord? Are you led to praise him? What? Leads you to give him praise.
Yeah.
What in his creation has led you to give him praise?
Mm-hmm.
To God be the glory. I think if oh my God, is a child name? Oh God.
It's
Hazel.
Hazel?
Yes. Boy, that little.
Woo! Jesus, have mercy. If Hazel could praise the Lord for his creation,
yes,
she would thank him for the deer.
Yes.
When they go out and feed the deer. She thanked him for the birds. When she see the birds flying and she said, that's a bird. She would thank him for the trees because she knows where the pine cones and leaves in the house. What in creation will cause you to praise the Lord?
My Lord.
To God be the glory. That's how I'm strong, though.
It does.
Whoa. Amen. Now, as we go to our... As we go to our sermon, amen, our song of inspiration, amen, you are the living word, amen.
Amen.
And you can stop that when it starts running the chorus wherever you are. Just watch me. Amen.
God with us, the living truth.
tremendous in God, we ask that you come and bring this word. Bring this word. Use me, Lord. Fill me up as I hide behind this sacred desk that has been dedicated to you. God, we thank you and we praise you. And I always ask, will the real preacher come? In your name, Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. As the scripture was read this morning by Brother Jackson Jordan, as we look and see how everything is getting ready now to start to line up to bring us into March 31st, the fifth Sunday, as we celebrate Resurrection Day. Amen. To God be the glory. I'm going to read to you the scripture from Matthew 4th chapter, verses 1 through 11 from the Message Bible. And it says, next Jesus was taken to the wild by the Spirit for the test. The devil was ready to get it. Jesus prepared for the test by fasting 40 days and 40 nights. That left him, of course, in a state of extreme hunger, which the devil took advantage of in the first test. Since you are God's son, speak the word that will turn these stones into loaves of bread. Jesus answered by quoting Deuteronomy, it takes more than bread to stay alive. It takes a steady stream of words from God's mouth. And for the second test, the devil took him to the holy city. He set him on top of the temple and said, since you are God's son, jump. The devil goaded him by quoting Psalm 91. He has placed you in the care of angels. They will catch you so that you won't so much as stub your toe on a stone. Jesus countered with another citation from Deuteronomy. Don't you dare test the Lord your God. For the third test, the devil took him to the peak of a huge mountain. He gestured expansively, pointing out all the earth's kingdoms. How glorious they all were. Then he said, they're yours. Lock, stock, and barrel. Just go down on your knees and worship me, and they're yours. Jesus' refusal was curt. Be it Satan. He backed his rebuke with a third quotation from Deuteronomy. What, worship the Lord your God and only him. Serve him with absolute single-heartedness. The test was over. The devil left. And in his place, angels. Angels came and took care of Jesus' needs. For a few moments, I want to lift up for you. Do you know when you are tested? Do you know when you are tested? The last verse from John 3, third chapter, tells us that Jesus came from Galilee to the Jordan to be baptized by John. John, feeling unworthy, tried to get Jesus to baptize him. And Jesus told him it had to be so for him to be baptized by him so that all righteousness could be fulfilled by them. As soon as he was baptized, he came out of the water. Heaven opened up and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting on him. Then a voice from heaven said, this is my son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased. This is somewhat paraphrased from the verses 13 through 17. That's kind of paraphrasing a little bit. Now the test begins. Jesus leaves and goes into the wilderness to fast and pray for 40 days and nights. He was in his fleshly body that moved and had all the signs of mortal man. He became tired, he became thirsty, he became hungry. We see from movies that he struggles to walk, the sun beaming down on him, dehydrating his body. And yes, I believe that the Lord would allow me to say that he was constantly praying to his Father. The only other time we see Jesus suffering is before and during the crucifixion. The scripture says that Jesus was led by the Spirit. Into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. He just wasn't there to fast, pray, and receive instructions from the Father. He already knew his orders, and he knew what had to happen in order for him to fulfill them. But he was led by the Spirit into the wilderness because he had to be tempted by
He was in his fleshly body. In the flesh, God had to see. My son, in the flesh, I got to see if you're going to be able to do this. What I set you for.
All right.
I got to see if you're going to be able to do it. Even though Satan knew he was the son of God, he thought he, in his mortal flesh, and experience the pain and suffering that he would give in. He thought 40 days was a long time, and not having anyone fast with him, that he could not make it. In the Old Testament, when prophets or men of God wanted to hear from God, they put on sackcloth and covered their bodies in ashes to show their humility as they came before the Lord. But in the New Testament, he tells us just wash your face. Wash it every morning that you're going to do your fast. Then anoint yourselves and move out through your day as if nothing is wrong. You ain't got to let people know that you out there fasting. You ain't got to go down there looking all pitiful and sad because you fasting for the Lord. They ain't got to know. You look like you're joyful and you're happy. Look like that's what's going on with you. But in your heart, you're speaking to God and meditating Him through hymns of praise.
Yes.
A study has shown that a body can only last 8 to 21 days without food and water. The philosopher, Dick Gregory, he fasted for 40 days. Dick Gregory he went without solid food for weeks to draw attention to a wide range of causes, which included the Middle East peace. Now that was back in the early 2000s.
Yeah.
You know, this is 2024. And he fasted for peace in the Middle East back in the beginning of the 2000s. He was fasting for U.S. hostages in Iran. Look where the hostages are now. Over there that they're trying to release. Romans got the hostages. They got them over there. They got them there. He was doing it for animal rights. How many dumb SPCA commercials you see on TV about the dogs and the cats?
My Lord.
People not feeding animals like they should.
Yeah.
They want a pet and keep it up and not doing what he was fasting back there in for that. Police brutality. Isn't that what we just had a few years ago and still happening?
Still happening.
Lord have mercy.
Mama.
The Equal Rights Amendment for women to support for women. He was fasting for the equal rights of women. They still out there voting, trying to get equal rights. To God be the glory. We already got a vice president female.
Yeah.
But people somewhere still fighting for equal rights.
Yes.
Lord
yes.
have mercy. And then it says he was fasting to support the pop singer Michael Jackson when he was charged with sexual molestation in 2004. Lord have mercy. So it really has a lot to do with your mind frame, fasting does. It has a lot to do with your health and the physical condition of your body. But Jesus, being led by the Spirit, was ready for the task he was to endure. Satan waited till he was sure that he would give in. So he waited till after his 40 days. His first test was to see if he was so hungry he would turn the stones into bread. If Jesus would have submitted, Satan would not have had to go any further with the testing.
That's right.
That would admit that Jesus did not trust God to help sustain him in his flesh, and that God did not trust him. Instead, the living word, the bread of life, he told Satan, first it is written. Then he proceeded to let him know that man shall not live on bread alone. But on every word that comes from the mouth of God.
Yes. Yes, he did.
This was round one of the test. And Satan failed. The second test, then the devil took him to the holy city, Jerusalem. Jerusalem, the temple in Jerusalem. And had him stand on the highest point of the temple and again use an imp. The devil was trying to establish doubt into the mind of Christ.
Yes.
Who already knows what it means to doubt and establish doubt. But if he is hungry and thirsty, he will be confused. So he says, if you are the Son of God, So that was the second test that Satan failed on. Well, if that wasn't enough, so again the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kings of the world and their splendor. That means the United States of America, Russia, China, Mexico, Brazil, Colombia, and told the word, which was Jesus, that was with God in the beginning, that was made flesh and now was dwelling among man, that he would give him if he bowed down and worshiped him. Now say, now say, you're getting to the point. You want me to worship you. You are a deceiver and a liar.
Yes.
You own nothing, and anything you want from God, you deceive people to get it. So now Jesus said, away from me, Satan. Because again, it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only.
Yes, yes.
Why do you think that Satan does not approach you every day? If he approached Jesus, you know he's approaching you.
That's right.
Every day. And it doesn't say that he approached him at any other time before this. After he was baptized and went into the wilderness, fasted for 40 days, here he comes to the Son of God and try to get him to doubt who he is. You see, once you have given Christ your life and believe that he is the Son of God, died for your sins, and resurrected so that you can have eternal life, that is when Satan has a problem with you.
That's right.
Why would he have a problem with you if you already belong to him?
Say so.
That's when he's trying to constantly visit you. He's trying to entice you.
Yes, he is.
And he brings demons with him to confuse you.
Yes, Lord.
Demons are real, y'all.
Yes,
they ain't made up. They're real.
They're real.
Once you start showing signs of confusion, he turns up the heat. Then he makes you believe your family has turned against you. He makes you believe people are talking about you. He makes you think that people are laughing at you when they hear bad things about you. And you feel that your employer is trying to set you up and make you quit your good paying job with awesome benefits. You feel that your church family is turning their back on you. And every time you try to pull yourself up by your bootstraps, they break. That's Satan and his demons.
Yes, yes, my Lord.
And if it's not God that you're going through that, it's not God forsaking you. Praise God in your circumstance.
That's right.
Wait patiently on him. He hear you cry. Call on the name of Jesus. Speak his name on your situation, your circumstance, your adversity, your calamities. Wait on the Lord and do not grow weary. We're studying in our Bible studies that God wants us to be patient. I know what I'm doing. Be patient, America. I know what I'm doing. Be patient, Israel. You know I know what I'm doing.
All right.
Be patient.
Yes.
So guess what? When you finish that test, here Satan comes with another one.
Yes.
But just remember how you passed the first one. And surely you're going to pass the second one, and the third one, and the fourth one, and the fifth one. You're going to pass it every time as long as you remember how you passed the first one.
Yes.
You passed.
As we stand on over. Donna Clarkin says, we fall down,
yes,
but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. For a saint is just a sinner who falls down and gets up. We thank God today for his love. We thank him for his mercy. We thank God that when we fall down, when we're being tested and we do fall down, we thank God that all we got to do is turn to him. Ask for forgiveness and he picks us right back. So to those of you who are joining us today on Facebook, if anybody is joining who don't know Christ in the pardon of their sins, I strongly urge you know him, yes. to come to know him.
Yes.
And all you got to do is say, I accept you, Jesus. You don't have to be in church to say that. But after you accept him and believe who he is and what he's here for and what he came for and his purpose and believe that he's coming back and get you to give you that eternal life that is so promised to you. Once you do that, go put yourself in a church home. Don't let nobody tell you that you can just continue to keep worshiping and praising God sitting in your house and you able to go and bring yourself among other believers. Don't let Facebook con you into thinking that. Because he wants us to fellowship.
Yes, he does.
He wants us to be able to go out and witness for him. He wants us to do that. That's your job. Once you get to know him. Once you get to know him. If you want to be baptized, wherever you go, you ask the pastor there and tell him you want to be baptized. And if he feels like you got to come to church and accept him in front of the whole congregation, be obedient. Because you know what you've already done.
That's
you
right.
know who you belong to. You know who you belong to. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. We thank you, God.
Yes,
if maybe somebody would say, I've already done that, but I have stepped out of the word. I stepped away from the Lord. You might think you stepped away from him, but he's still right there.
Yes, he is.
He's still right there with you, waiting on you to know what you've done. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Lord, we thank you.
Thank
we
you,
praise
God.
You. We give you glory for Lord, you are worthy.
Yes, you are.
You are worthy to be praised. Thank you, Lord,
thank
for
you,
your
God.
Word today.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, to let people know if Satan tested Jesus, you know he's going to test you.
Yes.
But we got to hold on
yes.
to your unchanging hand. We got to hold on. Hold on.
Yes.
And we know that what you have purposed for us, it will come to pass.
Yes, it
God,
will.
We thank you.
Thank you, God.
We thank you. And now may the peace of God that surpasses all understanding rest in the body of each and every one of us as we go through our week.
Yes.
Thanking God for every blessing and gift yes. that he gives us. And asking him to allow us to use it for his glory.
Yes.
And all the people sing.